So this is a little bit in depth. If you register a business with the Ministry of Commerce, especially if you register as a legal entity, so this information is legal entity. If you register as sole proprietorship, they don't ask for this information, less information. But if you register a proper standard company, so this information are a must to prepare and get ready before you register. Okay. You will do the company name searching. You search the company first. Some people use some names to do or to promote a business for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and they did not register. Once they search, the Ministry of Commerce rejected because of some reasons. Rejected, then they have to change. So they waste time on branding. They waste time on marketing because once they change the branding, it's completely new business. They don't know. And then you need to select business activity. You can choose business activity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 20 for your first registration with Ministry of Commerce. I put it in purple. The purple is our color brand, and it's important. You need proper office space. So either big or small, you need proper office space because the tax officer will inspect your office. To see if it is proper and it's something they want to see when they conduct audit in the future. So you need to either have small or big office, but it has to be proper. It looks like office space. What come along with the office space is rental contract and property tax receipt. You need to have a rental contract to indicate where it is exactly and how much money you pay per month because it's subject to tax, withholding tax on rent. And you need to ask for proper tax receipts from the landlord. And there are some business owner get stuck with this one. They register the business without having this one in place first. So the registration with the Ministry of Commerce did not ask for this one. They will only ask for this one. If the business owner has no this document, they will get stuck for step 2. And passport for foreigner. For ID card for Cambodian, photograph, standard photograph, residency address in their home country, if they are foreigner, residency address in Cambodia, for chairman, the person who represents the company only, telephone and email and article of incorporation. Many business owners do not know how to give the proper article of association or article of incorporation. The way you develop has to be compliant with the commercial policy. Some people try to register by themselves, but if they fail to develop this document properly, they will fail in the registration. And they blame why so long, why mess up, because they did not develop document properly. If you develop the document properly, you will submit and you will get your result based on the expectation or the procedure provided by the Ministry of Commerce. Until now, our company registered more than 200 companies. This document additional required document. If you register it as a subsidiary owned by a company abroad, or if you register a representative of your foreign company, or if you register it as a branch. So if you register those kind of business, you need this as additional document. For example, company certificate, article of incorporation or other legal document registered in your country or headquarters, and then letter of appointment, or they call it power of attorney. It has to be signed by the director and notarized by the notary public in that country. So these are additional supporting documents to register representative office, subsidiary or branch in Cambodia.
Making it easy. Making Cambodia easy.